felt I've had a wonderful life, especially the first 50 years, but I did not realize how incredible my life was going to be and change into a fabulous life to a spectacular life the day I met Alan Weisberg. And I have to credit my very dear friends, because even though Alan and I lived on the beach and our kids went to a lot of the same schools, we never really knew each other. And I was at a party one day with my dear friends, where are they? Jolie and Paul Cummings. And I was single at the time, and they said, we have a nice friend we want to introduce you to. And I didn't ask anything about him, what he does, where he lives, what he kind of car he drives. I just said, is he nice? Jolie said to me, he is the nicest man I have ever known. And I said, oh, then I would love to meet him. And I met him, and I not only realized he was the nicest man I've ever known, but he's a person who is so incredible in so many ways. So, not just smart and nice and wonderful, but a truly caring and sensitive human being. And not just about his loved ones or people he likes to be with, but for strangers. He reaches out to people everywhere. He stops, he wants to help people take pictures. You know, he says, you get the picture, let me take it. He loves animals, he loves our grandchildren, he loves all children. And every day when he comes home from work, it's like Christmas all over again. I see his face and it just makes me tickle inside. So the little project that I put together for this birthday party, because knowing my husband, who is not materialistic and doesn't care about gifts, I thought, what can I do? Something special for all his friends and loved ones who are coming. Let's all write love letters to Alan. So it was a wonderful project. I invited everybody to participate. I want to thank all of you for doing so. It was so interesting how the letters came in and the questions people asked. And I don't have formal awards, but I just want to mention the first love letter that came in right off the bat, the minute I sent out the request, was from our dear friend Glenn Terry, who hopefully is still here. Okay.
First in, first out.
Toward the end, people were a little panicky, and they said, oh, I didn't send it in yet. And I said, well, you better hurry. And they said, okay. So they were coming through email, overnight mail, UPS, FedEx, you name it. I thought the last letter that came in was this morning when my wonderful stepson Quentin came up and handed me his letter. However, his older brother went up to him because he handed me his letter tonight. So, our mutual gift from all of us to Alan
is this
box of love letters. By the way, several people said to me, well, what you think of my letter? I said, I did not read or screen the letters before I wrap them. This was your personal letter to Alan that he could open at his leisure. And I thought, you know, gifts can come and go. You can grow out of shirts. You can lose wallets. You can lose all kinds of things. But these letters are a gift from the heart from everybody, and you can have them for the rest of your life. And on top of that, some of the letters, our nephew, Michael Weisberg, sent the biggest package of all. And he sent me an email, is it gonna fit? I said, no, it's about the size of a shirt box. So I wrapped it in this. Here you go. And there's more in here, more to come, and more gifts. So anyway, love you, sweetheart. And thank you again, Debbie.